Student friends, in yesterday's lecture we studied the local loop associated with the telephone communication and we concluded that local loop is the network. It is the connection done by means of a cable, connection done by means of a wire between our telephone handset and that of the telephone exchange, through which the entire telephone communication between two subscriber that takes place, that network, that connection of the wire, which is known as the local loop. We studied the local loop since from the ancient time, where there was a human interference as an operator. Oldest type of the local loop, certain development took place, and nowadays without human interference the telephone communication that takes place with the help of VLSI technology, that is high speed integrated circuit, that helps the fast telephone communication. Timeless telephone communication, and also the large subscribers at a time are going to get connected with the telephone exchange, and this is possible only because of the development that took place in the field of electronic communication. With that particular aspect, let me introduce today the telephone tones. Friends, different telephone tones are used in the telephone communication. Each telephone tones have got their own meaning. The meaning is going to be understood by means of an every subscriber. Till and until that particular frequency tone is heard by the subscriber, subscriber will not adopt the steps, further steps in the telephone communication process. And that's why the telephone tone plays very important role from the point of view of subscriber to understand which step is to be taken. Which step is to be taken, it has the meaning that whether he has to dial the number, whether he has to receive the call, whether he has to recognize what exactly associated with the telephone exchange, whether the number is available, whether the number is engaged or not, everything is going to be understood by the subscriber just depending upon the nature of the telephone tone which will be heard through the speaker of the handset associated with a particular subscriber. Such a tones, we can call it as the telephone tones. Friends, different audio tones indicates different conditions when subscriber dials the number. It has the meaning that various types of telephone tones are used to indicate the condition of the telephone exchange, the condition of other subscriber. Whenever the subscriber wants to dial the number, so every tone, this indicates that every tone has a particular meaning By understanding that particular meaning only, the subscriber works with the telephone headset. The first telephone tone used is dial tone. When subscriber lifts the cradle of the handset to make a call, this one sentence gives the meaning of dial tone. Whenever subscriber wants to communicate with the other subscriber, he has to lift the cradle from the cradle switch. Means he has to bring the cradle switch on off condition. When the cradle switch is brought to off condition, immediately he heard the particular frequency tone from the telephone exchange. That particular frequency tone makes the subscriber alert that whether he is able to dial the number or not. That particular tone, we can call it as, it is a dial tone. It is a tone that makes the subscriber to dial the number. It is a tone that makes subscriber to decide whether he has to dial the number or not. That particular tone produced from the telephone exchange told the subscriber after lifting the telephone cradle switch is known as the dial tone. This means when subscriber lifts the cradle of the handset to make a call, a continuous tone of 33 hertz is heard, indicating that exchange is ready to accept the dialing number. After lifting the cradle switch, telephone exchange sends a tone of the frequency 33 hertz, very less frequency. Audible frequency is 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. Within that particular range, 33 hertz frequency tone is given by means of a telephone exchange to the subscriber. By hearing that particular tone, subscriber recognizes that exchange is ready to dial the number, or exchange is ready to accept the number dialed by the subscriber. This means that in Marathi we can call, till and until dial tone is given by the telephone exchange, one should not dial the number. In Marathi we can call, telephone exchange is alive. टेलिफोन एक्सचेंज जिवंत आहे, याचं इंडिकेशन म्हणजेच 33 हर्ट्झ फ्रिक्वेन्सीचा डायल टोन. वन्स द सबस्क्रायबर रिकॉग्नायझेस दॅट हर्ट्झ द डायल टोन, ही रिकॉग्नायझेस दॅट टेलिफोन एक्सचेंज इज रेडी टू ऍक्सेप्ट द नंबर डायल्ड बाय द सबस्क्रायबर, द नंबर शुड नॉट बी डायल्ड अंटिल डायल टोन इज हर्ड. Hence the dial tone plays a very vital role, and that is, till and until dial tone is heard, subscriber should not dial the number. So that is the meaning of the dial tone. Next one is a ringtone. A ringtone is the tone produced or heard by the subscriber through his handset to bring the attention of subscriber towards the telephone handset, indicating that someone is calling to that particular subscriber. In short, a ringtone indicates that some subscriber is calling to the handset calling to the other subscriber, where the handset starts ringing or it produces the ringtone. So that is the meaning associated with the ringtone. A ringtone means an interrupted tone of 133 hertz with the on time of 0.4 second and off time of 0.2 second is heard in calling subscriber's receiver when bell of calling party is ringing. Means when ringtone starts ringing from the telephone handset of the subscriber, it has a frequency of 133 hertz. It is interrupted tone. Interrupted tone means for certain interval the tone is off and for certain interval the tone is on. That on time period is 0.4 second and off time period is 0.2 second and total duration of ringtone including on tone and off tone, it is 0.6 second. This tone is heard with the help of the bell of the calling party when it starts ringing. This tone stops when called party lifts its cradle of the handset. Means ringtone will continue till the subscriber lifts the cradle of the handset for communication. So that particular tone, we can call it as, it is the ringtone. The next tone is number busy tone. Sometimes when called party is engaged, means when called party is speaking to another subscriber, then a busy tone is sent by the telephone exchange to calling party. Suppose we are calling to one of the subscriber and that subscriber is speaking with another subscriber. Under that particular condition, telephone exchange generates a busy tone and it is sent to the calling party to indicate that the subscriber to whom he wants to speak, he is busy or he is speaking with some other subscriber. So that is the indication of the number busy tone or buzzy tone. This tone has a frequency of 400 hertz and it is an interrupted tone with equal on and off time. Maybe on and off time is variable, but both the on time and off time are equal. So that interrupted tone, when heard by the subscriber who want to call, he recognizes that the number to whom he is calling, that number is busy with the other number. To indicate this particular aspect, the number busy tone is used. It has a standard of frequency 400 hertz and the tone is interrupted with the speciality that it has equal on time and equal off time. Then number not available tone. When dial number is out of order or it is a disconnected, then exchange sends continuous tone of 400 hertz to calling subscriber. Means suppose if there is any problem with the handset, if that dial number is out of order, if the telephone handset is disconnected from the telephone exchange, if there is any problem associated with the handset, then telephone exchange sends the continuous tone of 400 hertz to the calling subscriber to recognize that that number is not available or that number is dead, so that one has to give complaint to the telephone exchange by saying that there is a problem with that particular handset. Maybe there is a problem in local loop, or maybe there is a problem with the handset. Friends, these are the different telephone tones which are used, which has every tone has its own unique meaning to be recognized by the calling subscriber as well as the receiving subscriber. By using them, a very fruitful and faithful communication, telephone communication, is going to be achieving irrespective of the human interference automatically. Friends, nowadays we are using the mobile. In mobile, even all these tones are being heard by ourselves, and we are behaving according to that particular respective tone and undergoing a very successful telephone communication. Dear students, these are the different tones to be used in the successful telephone communication system. So that's all about today's lecture, which is associated with different tones which are to be used in the telephone communication, whose meanings are expected to be understood by the communicating two respective subscribers. That's all about today's lecture. Next time we'll go for next aspect of the telephone communication.